Hello friends, welcome to my channel Engineering Solutions. In this video, we will see the VCR cycle, that is Vapour Compression Refrigeration Cycle. First, we will understand the schematic of the Vapour Compression Refrigeration Cycle. So let's draw it first. There are the four basic components of the VCR cycle: compressor, condenser, expansion device and an evaporator. First, there is a compressor, then there will be the condenser, then expansion device, then evaporator, and again to the compressor. So these are the basic four components of the VCR cycle, and this is the path of the fluid flow, that is the refrigerant flow. For compressor, see, this is condenser, this is expansion device, and this is evaporator. Now let's understand the cycle. At the inlet of the compressor, the state of the refrigerant will be low pressure, low temperature, vapor refrigerant. So the low pressure, low temperature vapor refrigerant is entered into the compressor, and at the outlet of the compressor we'll be getting the high pressure, high temperature vapor refrigerant. So this high pressure, high temperature vapor refrigerant is entered into the condenser, where the heat is removed from the refrigerant, and at the outlet of the condenser we are getting high pressure, low temperature liquid refrigerant. Since the condensation process is at a constant pressure, so the pressure will remain same, that is high pressure. The temperature is decreases, so we are getting the refrigerant at the low temperature, and the phase of the fluid will be the liquid fluid, that is the liquid refrigerant. So this is high pressure, low temperature liquid refrigerant is entered into the expansion device, where the pressure is decreases. So at the outlet of the expansion device we will be getting the low pressure, low temperature, again the liquid refrigerant. This low pressure, low temperature liquid refrigerant is entered into the evaporator, where it absorbs the heat from the substance which is to be cooled, that is will be the water or food which is to be cooled. So after the expansion device we are getting the refrigerant in the low pressure, low temperature in the vapor form. So again this low pressure, low temperature vapor refrigerant is entered into the compressor, and this cycle is continuous. Now let's try to plot this VCR cycle onto the TS and PH chart. First, TS diagram, then PH. Before going to plot the VCR cycle onto the TS and PH diagram, we have to understand the TS and PH chart. So let's try to understand this first, then we will come back to the VCR cycle. First we will see the TS diagram, then PH diagram. So for TS diagram, in the vertical axis there is temperature, and on horizontal axis there is an entropy. So I have written S and T. Now let's draw the saturation curve. This is a saturation curve. Let's understand this first. This is a critical point of the saturation curve. This is a saturated vapor line, and this is a saturated liquid line. At the left of the saturated liquid line, the state of the fluid is liquid. At the right of the saturated vapor line, the state of the fluid is vapor. In between the saturation curve, the state of fluid is liquid plus vapor. Now let's see the constant pressure process on the TS diagram. The constant pressure lines on TS diagram are drawn like this. Now let's consider this constant pressure line. I will mark the process like this, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Consider the process 1 to 2. In this process, the temperature of the fluid is decreases till the point 2, we will be getting the fluid in the vapor state only. From process 2 to 3, there is a constant temperature and a phase change takes place. At the point 2, the fluid which is in the vapor state is converted into the liquid state. So at the point 3, we will be getting the fluid in the liquid state and there is no vapor particle at the point 3. Further cooling of the fluid and the point 4 is lies in the subcooled region. Now let's see this curve. I will mark in the opposite direction 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now consider the process 1 to 2. In this process, the temperature of the fluid is increases from point 1 to 2. At the point 2, till the point 2, the state of the fluid will be liquid. For process 2 to 3, the temperature remains constant and phase change takes place. At the point 2, the fluid state is liquid that will be converted into the vapor. At the point 3, we will be getting the fluid in the vapor state and there is no liquid particle at point 3. Further increase in the temperature of the vapor, we are getting the vapor fluid in the superheated form. Now let's see the pH chart. For the pH chart, vertical axis shows the P, that is pressure, and horizontal axis shows the enthalpy. Now we will draw the saturation curve for pH diagram. Saturation curve on the pH diagram will look like this. Same as on TS diagram, there will be the critical point. This is a saturated liquid line, this is saturated vapor line. Same as the TS diagram, at the left of the saturated liquid line, there will be liquid state. At the right of the saturated vapor line, there will be the vapor state. And in between the saturation curve, there will be liquid plus vapor region. So now let's draw the constant pressure line on pH diagram. As the vertical axis shows the pressure, so the constant pressure line will be look like this. It is a horizontal lines. Process will remain same. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a representation of this process onto the pH diagram and 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is a representation of this process onto the pH diagram. Now let's come back to the VCR cycle. So let's plot the TS and pH diagram. We'll draw the saturation curve on TS diagram. First I will explain the TS diagram, then pH diagram. Before that, we have to mark the point. This is point 1, this is point 2. That is process 1 to 2 will be compression, 2 to 3 it is a condensation, 3 to 4 it is a expansion process, and 4 to again 1 that is a evaporation. So let's plot the diagram onto the TS diagram first. So 1 to 2 is a compression process. Compression process is a isentropic process. And we will consider the standard VCR. In the standard VCR, it is assumed that at the inlet of the compressor, the state of the fluid is saturated vapor state. So this is point 1. It is on saturated vapor line. So this is point 1. It is an inlet at the compressor. Now the process 1 to 2 is a isentropic compression. That is the entropy is constant. So I have to draw the vertical line, point 2. This is point 2. Now as I said, the condensation is at the constant pressure and we know the constant pressure lines are drawn like this. So this is a process 2 to 3. In the standard VCR, it is assumed that at the outlet of the condenser, the state of the refrigerant is saturated liquid. So I have to mark the point 3 here. This is a point 3. Now the expansion process. 3 to 4 is an expansion process which takes place at the constant enthalpy. On the TS diagram, constant enthalpy lines are look like this, slightly curved. So this is point 4. And again the process 4 to 1 will be the constant pressure process. That is 4 to 1. So I have to draw the constant pressure line from 4 to 1. So So this is the cycle, and it is a thermodynamic representation of the VCR cycle onto the TS diagram. Now let's draw the thermodynamic cycle of VCR cycle on the pH chart. First, we have to draw the saturation curve. This is the saturation curve on pH diagram. This is the critical point. This is the saturated liquid line. This is the saturated vapor line. We have to mark the point 1. As we consider the standard VCR, thus point 1 will be on the saturated vapor line. So this is point 1. Now, as we know, the process 1 to 2 is constant entropy process. The constant entropy process on the pH chart are like this, slightly inclined line. So this is point 2. Since the point 2 on the TS diagram is on the superheated region, so in the pH chart it is also in the superheated region. Now the process 2 to 3 is the condensation process, which is a constant pressure. So in the pH diagram, the constant pressure line will be horizontal line. So this is point 3. And as we consider the standard VCR, the point 3 will be on the saturated liquid line. Now the process 3 to 4 is the expansion process. As I said, the expansion process, in the expansion process, the enthalpy remains constant. So the pH, in the pH diagram, the constant enthalpy line will be vertical line. So this is 4. Now the process 4 to 1 is again constant pressure. It is evaporation process. So it will be the horizontal line, and this is the thermodynamic representation of the VCR cycle onto the pH chart. Now let's see the COP of this cycle. COP is the desired effect divided by the input energy supplied. So desired effect will be the evaporation process. This is, so it will be the H1 minus H4. And the input energy supplied is to the compressor, so it is divided by H2 minus H1. So while solving the problem, especially for the getting the COP, we have to find out the enthalpy of the each point. In this, we have considered the standard VCR, that is the point 1 is lies on the saturated vapor line, and point 3 is lies on the saturated liquid line. That is the state of the fluid before entering the compressor is a saturated vapor, and after the leaving the condenser, it is a saturated liquid. There are other conditions also exist in which the point 1 and point 3 having the different position than the saturation curve. Let's see that conditions. The standard VCR cycle, standard means the point 1 lies on the saturated vapor line, point 3 is on the saturated liquid line. There may be the other condition that point 1 it may be not on saturated vapor line, and point 3 may be not on the saturated liquid line. So let's see that condition one by one. First, the point 1 in the standard VCR, which is on the saturated vapor line, it is in the vapor plus liquid region, that is in the saturation curve. The point lies in the saturation curve. So I will redraw the cycle on standard VCR itself. So let's mark this is point 1. It is in the liquid plus vapor region, that is in the saturation curve. The process 1 to 2 remain a constant entropy process. So this is point 2. I will mark this point as 1 dash and this as 2 dash. Then now this will be our new cycle, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 and 4. In this, there may be the condition that at the outlet of the compressor, that is point 2, the state of the refrigerant is saturated vapor. Means the point 2 is on the saturated vapor line. Previously, the point 1 is on the saturated vapor line. Now the condition is that the point 2 is on the saturated vapor line. So this will be our new cycle. I will mark here the 1 double dash and this point is the 2 double dash. So this is our new cycle, 1 double dash, 2 double dash, 3 and 4. Since in this particular case there is no any condition given for the point 3, so we will assume that the standard VCR condition for 0.3. Now this we will redraw the diagram for the pH diagram. So first 1' and 2'. So the point 1' is lies in the liquid plus vapor region, that is in the saturation curve. So this will be the point 1. Point 2 is in the superheated region. So this is point 2'. Now this is our new cycle in the pH diagram, 1', 2', 3 and 4. Second condition, we assume that the point 2 is on the saturated vapor line. So this will be our point 2. I will mark it as a 2", and this will be the point 1". So this is new cycle, 1", 2", 3 and 4. Now let's move to the next condition. In the next condition, the condition of the 3 point will be different than the standard VCR cycle. So first consider the point 3 is in the liquid plus vapor region. So this will be the point 3. I will mark it as a point 3'. And the process 3 to 4 will be remain same, that is constant enthalpy process. So this will be the point 4'. If there is no condition given for point 1 or 2, then we will assume the standard VCR for point 1 and 2. So our new cycle will be 1, 2, 3' and 4'. I will draw the diagram in pH chart. So this will be the point 3. 3 to 4 process is constant enthalpy process. So this will be the vertical line and this will be the point 4. Actually 3' and 4'. So this is a new cycle, 1, 2, 3', 4'. It may be that the condition of the point 2 is given, which is different than the standard VCR. So accordingly, we have to change the cycle. Like this, if the condition is given that the outlet of the refrigerant is saturated vapor, so this will be our point 2, and also the point 3 is lies in the vapor plus liquid region. So our cycle will be 1", 2", 3' and 4'. If the condition is given that the point 1 is in the liquid plus vapor region, point 2 is in the superheated region, and the point 3 is in the liquid plus vapor region. So we have to consider this cycle, 1', 2', 3' and 4', and same in the pH diagram. Now let's move to the next condition. Next condition is that point 3 is in the subcooled region, that is, it may be lies on this line, that is here. I will mark this as 3', this point is 3'. Now the process 3 to 4 will remain constant enthalpy process. This it will be meet on the constant pressure line here. I will mark it as a 4'. Actually, I have to mark the 3", 4". Now this is a new process, 3", 4". If the condition for the point 1 and 2 is not given, then we will assume that it is a standard VCR. So the cycle will be 1, 2, 3", and 4". For the same, I will modify in PA diagram also. So this will be our new point 3'. It is in subcooled region, and this is a constant enthalpy process, and this is 4'. So accordingly, we have to change the cycle. Means consider the cycle, the condition which is given in the problem. Now one more condition is that the point 1 is lies in the superheated region. Means the condition of the refrigerant at the inlet of the compressor is superheated. So the point will be 1 will be in the superheated region. So point 1 will be lies on this line. I will consider here how to extend the constant pressure line. So 1, I will mark is the 1". So this is the point 1. Now as the point 1 is already in the superheated region, the point 2 must be in the superheated region. So this is our new process, and remaining will be as per the given condition. So the accordingly cycle will be modified. So let's modify the diagram for this condition in pH chart. I will consider the point 1, which in the superheated region lies here. So this is 1 point. The process 1 to 2 will be remain same as a constant entropy process, and this is our new point 2 triple dash. The condition which is given in the problem, according to we have to consider the process 1 to 2 and 3 to 4. If the condition is not given or the data is insufficiently given, then we have to consider the standard VCR cycle. Thank you for watching this video. In next video, we will try to solve some numerical problem on the VCR cycle.